God bless you. Tonight we are going to pray to seek the face of God. Amen. Let me turn this down. God bless you so much. I believe that God has been good to you and I. The faithful God has been merciful to you and I. Amen. This evening we are going to seek the face of God in prayer. It's 9:41 here in America, East Coast. So I can say this evening or maybe tonight we are going to seek the face of God. I just want to encourage you to get your Holy Bibles. You know, as we're about to pray, I want to encourage you to get your Holy Bibles, because we are going to pray based on the Word of God. Amen. God bless you, Salma. God bless you. I want you to get your Holy Bibles, because we'll be praying based on the Word of God. Amen. I always say on scriptural prayers, I just like speaking or insulting someone on a TV. You know, when you pray and your prayer is not based on the Word of God, it's just like watching a TV and insulting someone. Amen. So you always have to pray based on the Word of God. So please get your Holy Bibles ready wherever you are. Please make sure you pick your Holy Bible, because we are going to pray based on the Word of God. Amen. We are going to pray based on the Word of God. So please get your Holy Bible. In the next 2-3 minutes, we are going to dive into the Word of God and be praying. Amen. Tonight we'll be doing a lot of prayers, but I need you to please get your Bible. Amen. Yes, as I'm playing this song in the background, just, you know, get your Holy Bible ready. Go get your Bible. Amen. Let me bring it closer. Please get your Holy Bible. Get your Holy Bibles ready. We're about to pray to seek the face of God. Amen. God bless you, Nisha. We're about to pray to seek the face of God. So please, wherever you are, get your Holy Bible. Because on scriptural prayer, it's just like insulting someone, you know, on TV. When you are praying and your prayer is not based on the Word of God, it is like insulting someone on TV. Amen. So I encourage everybody to get your Holy Bibles ready, because we are going to be praying based on the Word of God. So as the song is playing in the background, let's, you know, get ourselves ready. Amen. Blessed Prince. We are calling the Holy Trinity. God in three persons. Blessed Prince. Amen. Beloved, I want you to understand that I believe for most of us watching, I believe it is almost nighttime, or maybe nighttime or midnight, wherever you are. Amen. I believe for most parts of the world, it is either nighttime, midnight, or dawn. Amen. And so it is very important. You know, this is some of the best times to feed your spirit with the Word of God. Amen. This is one of the best times to feed your spirit, so that when you go to sleep, the Holy Spirit of God will be speaking to you. Amen. And so I want you to get your Holy Bibles ready. Before we do anything, let's pray in the name of the Lord Jesus, inviting the Holy Spirit of God to minister to you. Amen. Wherever you are, you want to pray and invite the Holy Spirit of God. You say, have you been to church and the preacher is preaching or ministering, and you know that this word is for me? Amen. This prayer topic is for me. Amen. And so as you are praying, you are going to ask the Holy Spirit of God that let this sermon, let this session be for me. Let every prayer that will be praying be for me. Amen. And let it break me through in life. Amen. Because this prayer, tonight's broadcast, by the grace of God, I have captured it, chance. Amen. Chance is a possibility of something happening. Amen. Chance chance is a possibility of something happening. Amen. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 9:11, Solomon said, the race is not to the swift, neither is battle to the strong, nor food to the wise. You know, Solomon is saying that it is not about the one with skill, the one with competence, the one with knowledge, the one with strength. Amen. But Solomon identified two things. He says it is either time or chance. Amen. Time is planned. Chance just happens. Amen. So Solomon says it is either time or chance that makes things happen for people. Amen. So time, you know, as the name connotes, time is planned. You plan it. But chance is when something just happens. Amen. For instance, I don't think you planned to join me in prayer tonight, because this is not planned. Amen. And so this is chance. Hallelujah. This is chance. And most of the time, if you read your Bible very well, I believe you do, most of the times, almost every miracle that Jesus performed were miracles that happened by chance. Amen. Hallelujah. Almost every miracle that Jesus performed were miracles that happened by chance. He did not plan them. He would just be passing by. For instance, Jesus' first miracle in John chapter 2, when he went for the wedding, Jesus, the Bible says, there was a wedding, and Jesus and the disciples had been invited, and Mary was also there. Amen. So Jesus and the disciples had been invited not to come and perform miracles, not to come and do anything. They were just invited to come and sit there, come and enjoy, come and witness the wedding. Amen. So it wasn't planned. You know, it wasn't planned for Jesus to come and perform. As a matter of fact, they didn't know that Jesus could perform miracles. Amen. But they had just invited him. But when it came to pass that they were out of wine, because they chanced to see, because by chance Jesus happened to be there, you know, he performed that miracle for them. Amen. Almost every miracle Jesus performed in the Bible were miracles. They were things that happened by chance. Amen. The Bible said one day he was passing by a blind Bartimaeus, a man that had been blind for years. Amen. He heard that Jesus was passing by. It was never planned. Amen. It was never orchestrated. It just happened by chance that Jesus was passing by. Jesus had a planned destination. Amen. And so the Bible says when blind Bartimaeus heard that Jesus was passing by, you know, we all know what he did. He screamed on top of his voice, Jesus, Jesus, you know, they will not allow him. And he said, Son of David, be merciful to me. And then, by chance, this guy, a man that had no hope of ever seeing, you know, because of chance, he was able to see. Amen. Beloved, why am I saying this? I want you to understand that, you know, like someone said, it is either time or chance that makes people break through in life. And so this prayer section, I know it is not by time, because it was never planned, because you never plan to pray with me at this time. But by chance, in the name of Jesus, there is a miracle that is about to hit you. There's a miracle that is about to happen for you because of this opportunity, because of this chance, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, another example before you even pray, another example of someone that received her miracle by chance is the woman that had been bleeding. Amen. Now, watch this. The Bible said this woman had been bleeding for years. I think for 12 years or maybe. Now, Jesus Christ was passing by. The Bible said the woman heard, which means Jesus was even out of her sight. Amen. Because she just heard, God bless you, the woman just heard that Jesus was passing by. Now, by chance, because she heard that Jesus was passing by, she did not just sit there, she did not just stand there, she did not just relax. Amen. And this is a woman that had lost all hope. The Bible said the doctors had done their best Amen. And so she had spent all her money, and so almost every hope was gone. And for so many of us, in certain areas of our lives, we have given up. Amen. But I came and I prophesied in the name of Jesus that by this chance, just as it happened to the woman that doctors had given up on, the woman that she had given up on herself, by this chance, a breakthrough, a miracle is about to hit you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Chance, tonight's prayers, by the grace of God, I have captioned it chance, because it was never planned. Amen. So Solomon said, it is either time or chance that makes things happen. It is not by skill, it's not by competence, it is not by anything, but it is two things that makes things happen, either time or chance. Time is when things are planned. Amen. Things are scheduled. Things are orchestrated. By chance, just happens. Amen. And so, like, by the grace of God, by the examples I have given, almost every miracle that Jesus did in the Bible were miracles that happened by chance. You know, he would just be going, you know, passing by, and the blind Bartimaeus, you know, would be screaming, and he gets his healing. You know, even the woman that had committed adultery, the Bible says, you know, she was running. Listen, it was never planned that Jesus would be standing there waiting for someone that is being chased. Amen. The woman was running away, and then she chanced to meet Jesus. Amen. And even though she had sinned, because people argue that she didn't sin, she didn't commit adultery, you know, she didn't commit the sin. But remember, when after Jesus redeemed her, Jesus told her that go and sin no more, which means yes, she had sinned. Amen. She had committed adultery, but guess what? Even though she had committed adultery, even though she had sinned, even though she had committed that sin, the Bible says as long as she was running away and she bumped into Jesus, she chanced to meet Jesus. By that chance, by that opportunity, she was relieved, or she was saved from being stoned to death. Amen. Beloved, like I am saying, by the grace of God, tonight we are about to pray. And by this chance, if you will not sleep, if you pay attention and take advantage of this chance, I know this is never planned. I know you never planned, but if you can spare me about 30 minutes of your time, if you can spare me about an hour of your time, however the Holy Spirit of God is going to lead us, I could have stayed in my home and prayed by myself, but I want you to know that chance makes things happen. Amen. And every miracle you are believing God for, every breakthrough you are believing this God for, by this chance, by this opportunity to pray, something good is about to happen for you in the name of Jesus. Chance. Don't give up. Chance is going to make things happen for you. Solomon said, the race, thank you for sharing, God bless you. Solomon said, the race is not to the swift, neither is the battle to the strong, nor skill, nor, you know. So Solomon is talking about people with skill, people with potentials, but Solomon is saying that it is not by your skill, it's not by your competence, it is about time and chance. Because I have seen skillful, educated people, people that are strong, dying, struggling, being poor. They had the skill, they had the strength, they had the energy, they had the education, but they are struggling. So it's not about potentials, it's not about skill. It is good to have them, but Solomon, like Solomon rightfully put it, it is about time, how you schedule things, how things are orchestrated, or by chance. Hallelujah. And this prayer, by the grace of God, this session is called chance, because it is unplanned. And by this chance, you know, when you look for the definition of chance, it is the possibility of something happening. Amen. Chances are either low or high. Chances are either, you know, possible or impossible. It is based on how you maximize that chance. Amen. So this is a chance for you to get your miracle, you know, but the burden, you know, if you can get your breakthrough, it will not depend on me. It will depend on how you maximize this chance. Amen. This is an opportunity to break through in life. This is an opportunity to get something from the sovereign God, but you have to maximize that chance. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 5, that at the pool of Bethesda, watch this. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Listen, this is a good example for time and chance. The Bible says at the pool of Bethesda, occasionally or momentarily, the angel of the Lord will come and stir the water. So this is time here, because there was a time, a season, that the angel of God will come and stir the water. And so by that time, you are able to get your healing. Now, this is a man that was lame. He had been there for 38 years. Now, when you read your Bible very well, John chapter 5, the Bible says, everybody that was there was either blind, lame, or paralyzed. Amen. So this is a healing you can get by time, because at a particular season, you know, of the year, the angel by certain time will come and stir the water. So whoever is fast, again, it is time. Amen. Because it takes time to be able to determine who is fast or slow. Amen. So whoever is fast by time, whoever is fast to drop themselves in the pool will get their healing. This is a man that can't walk. He can see, he has hands, but he was there for 38 years. Even blind people who cannot see are getting their healing. But this guy had been there. You know, he had a chance, but he wasn't maximizing the chance. He wasn't planning his chance. But guess what? Because we serve a merciful Father, even though the guy was not taking advantage of the time, even though the guy was not mastering the time, even though the guy had been there for 38 years, at least he could have made certain steps. He could have, studied the times and the seasons that the angel comes. Amen. You can't tell me that everybody that had been there, you know, everybody that gets their healing has to be there for 38 years. No. Amen. So time was not working for the guy. Fast forward. You know, so time was not working for this lame man. Amen. But the Bible says Jesus appeared to him. This is chance. Amen. So time wasn't working for him, but Jesus appeared to him. John chapter 5. Jesus appeared to this man. Amen. So this is chance. Now, you know, when the angel comes at a certain season, which is time, the guy wasn't getting his healing. He wasn't able to catch that time. And so the time wasn't working for him. Like Solomon said, it is time and chance that makes things happen. Amen. So the time wasn't working for the man. But Jesus appeared to the man, which is chance. Amen. And now, instead of him to take advantage of this chance, this guy had a complaint. He said, when the angels come, he's even talking about the past. And for so many of you, if you're not careful, instead of taking advantage of this chance, you are going to talk about your past. That, oh, me, I have been praying and nothing is happening. Listen, I came in the name of Jesus to let you know that if you take advantage of this chance, this very moment, and pray in the name of Jesus, something is about to happen for you. This is the man who had all the time for himself, 38 years for himself. How many seconds do we have in 38 years? How many minutes do we have in 38 years? How many hours do we have in 38 years? He had all the time for himself, but he wasn't taking advantage. Now, Jesus himself, God himself, the healer himself, came to him, appeared to him, and all this guy could talk about was complain. He said, when the angels come, he was talking about the past. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, this evening, if you forget about the past, yes, I know you have been praying. Yes, I know you've been sowing seeds. Yes, I know you've done your best, but nothing is happening. Yes, time hasn't worked for you, but this chance is going to break you through in the name of Jesus. And I prophesy in the name of Jesus that as we're about to start to pray, if you will pray too, something will happen for you. Holy Spirit, watch over your word and perform it in the name of Jesus. And so Jesus is standing in front of the man. Jesus asked him, I am the healer. Do you want to be healed? Say yes. He said, he started complaining, talking about the past. When the angels come, you know, so that is how many of us we are. We think someone has to help us. We incriminate people because they haven't done certain things for us. But tonight, in the name of Jesus, I came to let you know that you must have an absolute dependency on Jesus Christ alone. You must have an absolute dependency on Jesus Christ. The Bible says, for the mother may forsake the second child. The mother may forsake the second child, the baby that is sucking out of the breast. Even the mother may forsake her or them. But God will never forget and forsake you. He said, I will never let you down. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Tonight you're about to pray in the name of Jesus. This is chance. The very things we've been praying about for years, that hasn't happened. This is chance. Believe, have faith, and make a move in prayer and see what God will do for you. I came to stir up your faith that by prayer, if only you can believe. Listen, like I said earlier, almost every miracle Jesus performed in the Bible were miracles that happened by chance. They happened by chance. Opportunity. This is an opportunity for you. We're about to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to get your Holy Bible. You know we can't pray without reading from the Bible. Amen. Even though I've been quoting Bible verses, but it will be more powerful to pray based on the Word of God. Amen. Read your Bible and pray. Amen. Yes, let's get our Bibles. Hallelujah. Okay, so I want us to turn our Bibles to the book of the Holy Spirit, give me a word. Let's pray. Let's turn our Bibles to Psalm 20. Amen. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of Psalm 20. Please make sure you have your Bible with you. Amen. Psalm 20. Thank you, Holy Spirit. This evening, we are about to pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. We are about to pray in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. We are about to pray in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. And I want you to take every prayer very seriously. Amen. You know, as we are praying, listen to this key. I'm going to give you this key. You know, the Bible says in Hebrews 4:12 that the word of God is very active and sharper. The Bible says it is likened unto a double-edged sword. Amen. The Bible says it is likened unto a double-edged sword. Amen. That is how powerful the Word of God is. Hallelujah. That is how powerful the Word of God is. And so we are about to pray in the name of Jesus. And so as you are praying, when I bring the prayer topic up, amen, and you are praying, as you are praying, make sure you are also going reading through the scripture that I gave. Amen. Because as you do that, it gives your spirit power. Amen. It fills your spirit with strength. So for instance, when I give a first prayer topic, and let's say I quote from Psalm 20 verse 1, and I say, let's pray about this by the grace of God, as the Holy Spirit leads, make sure as you are also praying, yes, close your eyes, but once in a while, open your eyes, and then make sure you are reading through the scripture that I gave. Amen. That is how your prayer will work. This is a key. It is a very strong key. And by this key, you are using the word of God. That is how Jesus was able to defeat the devil. He kept saying, it is written, it is written, it is written, it is written. Jesus knew the Bible. Jesus is the word himself. He could have told Satan that this, but he quoted the word. Amen. That is how you defeat the devil. Hallelujah. Please share this video so that someone else can also get a miracle by this chance. Amen. Also, for you have a bumpy wife. Yeah, we're about to pray. And so we're about to pray. So please turn your Bibles to Psalm 20. Amen. Please turn your Bibles to Psalm 20. We are going to pray in the name of Jesus. So I want everybody to have your Bibles in front of you. Amen. That is how you will get something, a miracle, and a breakthrough from it. Amen. You don't want to waste your time, you know, just talking. Hallelujah. Psalm 20 verse 1. I am reading. Psalm 20 verse 1. Also, are you on the line? Yeah, okay. Psalm 20 verse 1. Amen. I'm reading. Okay. It says, The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Amen. So we are going to pray based on Psalm 20 verse 1. You know, it says, God bless you. Please get your holy Bibles. It said, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. Amen. I believe you are troubled. I believe, yes, you may be happy. Yes, I'm happy. But there is something I am troubled about. Amen. There is something I'm not happy about. Amen. There is something you are not happy about. The Bible says, is anybody sick among you? Let them pray. Let them pray. Amen. Is anybody happy? Let them sing praises. Amen. And so you are going to pray. I don't know where you have that trouble. There is something that you are troubled about. Amen. There is something you want God to do for you. Hallelujah. There is something, just like the woman that was bleeding, just like the woman that had issues with the blood, just like the man that, you know, had been at the pool of Bethesda for 38 years. There is something that God must touch. There is a breakthrough you must get. There is a miracle you must get tonight. And as you're about to pray, the Bible says, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Amen. This is how we are going to pray. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus. The Father, may you hear me. Amen. And you are also going to pray that may the God of Jacob defend me. Amen. And so you are going to pray that, Father, as I open my mouth and I pray, may you hear me. May you hear me. And may the God of Jacob defend me. Amen. May God defend you from every struggles of the enemy, every attack of the enemy. Somebody open up your mouth and pray. Pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let's pray in the name of Jesus. That may God hear us. May the Lord defend us. May God hear us. Let's pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Le ba 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 ya karada brusha. Le ba ya ba. Le kere de ma kaba ba ya ba. Le bre kare de ma sheka papa. Le ba de ma sheka ba ya ba ya ba. Somebody open up your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. You are praying that may God hear me. You are praying, as you are praying, make sure you are reading Psalm 20 verse 1. It says, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. May the name of God of Jacob defend me from every attack of the enemy, from every sickness, from every pain, from every challenge, from every struggle. May God of Jacob defend me. May the God of Jacob defend me. Somebody open up your mouth and pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Le ba 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 ya kada da brata, le bre kada da brata, le bre kada da brasha, le ba 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 kababa, le ba 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 kababa, le bre kada ramashe kaba. You are praying to the Lord. The Lord, may you hear me. Lord, may you hear me. Lord, may you hear me. Mashe kaba ba ba ba, and may you defend me, Father. May you defend me in the day of trouble, Father. May you defend me in the day of trouble. I am struggling. I am sick. I am poor. Somebody open up your mouth. You know what you are going through. Pray that, God, may you defend me. The devil is laughing at me. My friends are laughing at me. People are laughing at me. Father, may you defend me. God of Jacob. God of Jacob. Somebody open up your mouth. You are praying that may the God of Jacob defend me. May the God of Jacob defend me. Don't just say God. Make sure you are saying the God of Jacob. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 6, when Jesus was teaching them to pray, he said, our Father, in one tone, to say, the one that is in heaven. When you say our Father, a shrine may be claiming your prayer. When you say our Father, a fetish priest may be claiming your prayer. That is why you must say, the God of Jacob, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, may you defend me. May you defend me. Open up your mouth. Somebody pray. Masika baba yaba. Lebre karara broche katata, le pakatata yabrata, le baba baka baba, le baba baba kababa, le kababa baka baba, le kababa baba kaba, le kababa baba kaba, le karara broche kaba, le braka baya braka ba, You are crying to the Lord that God, may you defend me. May you hear me, Lord. 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 May you hear me as I cry to you. May you hear me as I pray to you. God of Abraham, God of Jacob, may you hear me tonight. May you hear me this evening. This is the chance to meet with the Lord. This is your chance to receive a breakthrough. Somebody open up your mouth and pray that God of Jacob, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, may you hear me. May you hear me. He said, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Somebody, as you are praying, make sure you are reading the Bible verse I've given you. As you are praying, make sure you are glancing through it. Quote it. Let's open up your mouth. The Bible says, Jesus would say, it is written, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. May the name of the Lord of Jacob defend me. May the name of the Lord of Jacob defend me. Somebody open up your mouth. Lift up prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. May God hear me. Say, God of Jacob, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, Father, may you hear me. Father, may you hear me. Somebody open up your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. Masheka bababa, masheka bababa, masheka bababa, masheka bababa, leka baya baya ba, masheka bababa, leke bede bede be, leka baba baba ya ba, leka baba baya ba, leka baba baya ba, leka baba baba ya, lepre kapaya, leke petete. May the Lord hear me. May the Lord hear me. The God of Jacob, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Verse 2, Psalm 20, verse 2. God bless you, Apostle Amankwa. God bless you, Apostle Collins from Worcester. Amen. God bless you, so forth. Amen. Okay, so Psalm 20, verse 2. Amen. Psalm 20, verse 2. Amen. It says, send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Amen. Listen, no matter who you are, God will have to use someone to bless you. Amen. God will have to use, God bless you, Mama Sylvia, blessing. God bless you so much. Amen. No matter who you are, God will have to use someone to bless you. Amen. God does not come down to work. He works through vessels. Amen. That is why in Ezekiel he said, I sought for one man to stand in the gap. Beloved, if you just joined us, the reason why we are doing this, or the reason why I've captured this chance, is that, you know, God works in two ways, according to how Solomon said in Ecclesiastes. He said, it is either time or chance that happens. Amen. It is time and chance that makes things happen. Amen. It's not by your skill. It's not by your potentials. Amen. He said, the race is not to the swift, but it is time and chance, you know. And so time is when you plan certain things. Amen. Time is when you have scheduled your time yourself, but chance is just something that just happens. Amen. And I gave, by the grace of God, I gave, you know, we use a case study in John chapter 5. In John chapter 5, a man that was blind had been there for 38 years. Now, he had all this time. The 38 years was the time he had to himself, but he could not maximize his time. Amen. He could not get, God bless you to Apostle. He could not take advantage of the time. You know, he could not get his healing, you know, during those time of the 38 years. Now, as he was still there, Jesus, the healer himself, God himself, came to him, appeared to him. That was chance. Amen. That was chance. Amen. That was an opportunity. Now, Jesus asked him, do you want to be healed? I am the healer. I am asking you, do you want to be healed? Now, the guy started talking about the past, talking about how when the angels come, he has nobody to help. Amen. Beloved, listen, you know, don't talk about the past. I know you have prayed, you know, in the past you've been praying, but this is a chance. Amen. This is an opportunity to break through in life. This prayer, by this prayer, by tonight's prayer, something will happen for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. We are going to pray our second prayer. We are going to pray that may God send help to us. Amen. He said, may God send help from the sanctuary. Amen. You know, it doesn't necessarily mean help from your church. It can come from, God decides where it will come from. Amen. But the sanctuary, you know, usually it is talking about the heavenlies. Amen. Angels, may God send help to you. Amen. Whoever God will use, however God will bring it, you are just asking God. The Bible says in James 1:17 that every good and perfect gift comes from God. Amen. For so many of us, we have depended on men. We have certain people that we expect certain things to come from. Amen. Just as the lame man at the pool of Bethesda, he was waiting for people to push him in instead of having an absolute dependence on God. We are praying in the name of Jesus. We are praying in the name of Jesus that may God send help to us. Amen. May the Lord send divine helpers to us. Amen. May the Lord send divine helpers. Help us that will. Listen. In the Bible, there are two kinds of divine helpers that, as far personally, that I noticed in the Bible. Now, when you read Acts chapter 3, please allow me to say this so that, because I want all this is prayer. Amen. So even as you are listening to me, pray within you. Amen. Even because all this, you have, as you feed your spirit with the word of God, it makes your prayer powerful. Amen. Yes. That's why the Bible says, you know, the Bible says we should not quench the spirit. Amen. We are feeding the Bible. You know, this is building our spirits up. So watch this. In Acts chapter 3. Now, the Bible said there was a lame man, a boy that had been lame from birth. Now, this boy, some people would go and carry him daily, every day, and place him at the beautiful gates to beg for money. Every day, they will carry him. He needs help. They are helpers. Without them, he cannot move. But they placed him at the beautiful gates to beg for money. Amen. They placed him at the beautiful gate to beg for money. Watch this. Now, in Mark chapter 2, another group of people carried another lame man, someone just like the one in Acts chapter 3. Now, they carried him. When they got there, Jesus was preaching. There was a church. Both, you know, both the destinations of both lame people were churches. Amen. Now, watch this. In Mark chapter 2, when the people got there, the church was crowded. It was full. You know, there was no more space. They could have left the man at the entrance, or they could have given up on the man. But the Bible said they went ahead even to destroy the roof to make sure that they place the lame man at the feet of the Jesus. Amen. Now, you see the difference here. The helpers of Acts chapter 3, they drew, it was like they were helping the guy, but they drew a limitation for him. They just placed him at the entrance of the church. But when Peter and John got there, they told the man, "Silver and gold we do not have, but such as we have, we give you." What did they give? They gave prayer. Now, this is a man that could have started walking by prayer, but he was given a limitation. He had been drawn a limitation where prayer is going on. Instead of them taking him into the church, they drew a limitation. This is where you belong. Sit at the entrance, beg for money. Let everybody know that you are in need. You don't want that kind of destiny helpers. You want the destiny helpers of Mark chapter 2. Amen. We want the destiny helpers of Mark chapter 2. Help us who will not give up on us. Help us who will not let everybody know that I am the one helping. Without me, they cannot go ahead. They cannot progress. Because that is what the helpers of Acts chapter 3 were doing. Amen. Beloved, we are going to pray in the name of Jesus. You are going to pray that may God send helpers to you. Helpers who will not give up on you. Amen. Helpers who will not draw limitations for you. Amen. Helpers that will accomplish their task. Amen. Helpers who will not show off. Listen, the helpers of Mark chapter 2, when the place was congested, they could have made noise. Hey, give us way. The guy is lame. The guy can't walk. To let everybody know that they are the ones helping him. But the Bible says they moved around, hid themselves, and dropped the man. They didn't show themselves up. Amen. Those are the kind of helpers that you need. Helpers who will not show off. Amen. Helpers who will not tell the whole world. You need a helper that you will testify that this person helped me. God used that person to help me. Not helpers who will draw limitations, place you at the entrance of where you can get your breakthrough. Amen. Somebody, I want you to open up your mouth. Psalm 20 verse 2. It said, may God send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Open up your mouth and pray. May God send divine helpers to you. Helpers who will not give up on you. Helpers who will make sure you reach your destination. Helpers who will make sure you reach your destination. You get your healing. You get your breakthrough. You get your testimony. Open up your mouth and pray. Somebody, by this chance, by this opportunity, something good is about to happen. Open up your mouth and pray for divine helpers. That helper can be your husband. That helper can be your wife. That helper can be your ministry partners. That helper can be your acquaintance. Open up your mouth. Pray in the name of Jesus. Maya Bakada. Open up your mouth and pray. You are speaking to God. He said, may God send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. May the Lord help me. God, may you send me help. Father, may you send us help. May you send us help. Divine helpers. Divine helpers. Divine helpers. Divine helpers. Divine helpers. Leke bebe bebe bebe. Leke bebe bebe bebe. Leke ba 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 ya. Leke bebe bebe bebe. Le ba 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 ya ba. Le bebe bebe bebe. Malala la brocha. Somebody open up your mouth and pray. May God send you divine helpers. May the Lord send you divine helpers. May the Lord send you divine helpers from the sanctuary. Make sure you are reading. Make sure you are glancing through Psalm 20 verse 2. It says, send thee help from the sanctuary. May God send you helpers. Somebody open up your mouth. Leke brekaba, leke brekaba, leke brekaba, leke brekaba. Oh Lord, my God, may you send me help, Lord. Father, may you send me help, Lord. I cannot do it on my own. May you send me help, Lord. 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 Somebody open up your mouth. Your divine helper may be in the immigration office. Your divine helper may be at your workplace. May God send you help. Someone that will favor you. Someone that will promote you. Someone that will approve you. Pray for help. May God send you 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 help. Wherever it is impossible, where it seems impossible, may the Lord send you help. Say, oh Lord, send thee help from the sanctuary. May you release your angels. You release your angels. Father, bring me help, Lord. Bring me help, Lord. Bring me help, Lord. Bring me help, Lord. Somebody open up your mouth. May God send you help. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We are going to take that prayer again. Listen. The helper can be in an office. Amen. A place you need a favor. Amen. Everybody may say no. Everybody may say no. They will not approve. They will not agree. But God can send you help over there. That one person. Oh, just one person over there. And that help will be the person that has the final say. Amen. You are going to pray in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. That helper, divine helper that God can send you, can also be your spouse, your wife, your husband. Amen. As a matter of fact, in life, one of your greatest helpers is your spouse. Amen. Maybe you are already married. We are going to pray that may God tell your spouse to be that helper. May God give them the wisdom they will need to help you. You are going to pray. Your helper can be your friend. The divine helper can be somewhere you never know. Amen. A favor you need in an office, may God send you help over there. Something you can't do by yourself. A wisdom you need, a favor you need, an elevation you need. Open up your mouth and pray that may God send you helper, divine helper, divine helper, and angels that will fight for you, angels that will bring that child, that baby you are looking, the fruit of the womb. Somebody open up your mouth. God is touching your fruit, your womb. God is giving somebody a baby. God is giving somebody a baby, the fruit of the womb. God is giving it to you. By this chance, you are receiving that baby in the mighty name of Jesus, that divine helper. It is coming in the form of an angel. Somebody pray by the power of the Holy Ghost. May God send you help. May God send you help. He says, send thee help from the sanctuary, from the heavenlies. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 10, when the prince of Persia was resisting the angel, the Bible says, and God sent another angel. May God send a backup help in the form of an angel. Open up your mouth and pray. May God send me help. May God send you help. Oh Lord, may you send us help. May you send us help from the heavenlies, from the sanctuary. Oh Lord, God of Jacob, God of Abraham, send us help. Kakakapa, lipatuyata, lebebebeyapa, lekatayaba, lebrentaya, 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 lekadadaba, lebabayaba. My God, my God, may you send us help. Somebody open up your mouth and pray that God will send you help. 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 Open up your mouth and say, Jesus, Son of David, be merciful to me and send me help, Lord. In Jesus' name. Masukuba. Hallelujah. Makubra katiyaka. Verse 3, Psalm 20, verse 3. Please get your Bible and make sure you are reading, you are going through the Bible. Amen. As you are praying, when I give the prayer topic, make sure you are also reading the verse that I give. Amen. That is how you give your spirit power. Amen. It's very important. Make sure you're also reading. And so as you are praying, you know, you will pause and read, let's say, sending help from the sanctuary. Read, you know, as it is written, read it. It gives your spirit power to overcome the devil. Amen. Take it serious, okay? Okay. Verse 3, Makabrusha. Psalm 20, verse 3. He said, remember, so these are prayers, amen. He said, may God remember all thy offerings, amen, and accept thy burnt sacrifice. Selah. Amen. Now watch this. In the Bible, in the book of Acts chapter 10, the Bible said there was a man, a centurion, a soldier called Cornelius. Now the Bible said he was a man of prayer. He was also a good man, someone that gives alms, someone that helps those that are in need. He was also a man that committed all his family, or converted his family to be Christians. Amen. Now watch this. The Bible says it was about 3 p.m. Acts chapter 10. An angel, verse 3. The Bible says an angel of the Lord appeared to Cornelius. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says an angel of the Lord appeared to Cornelius in a vision, like a trance in the revelation, OP revelation. And he said to Cornelius, the Cornelius, your prayer and your alms have been a memorial before the Lord. Amen. For anything to be a memorial, it means it is immortalized. It means it's been written. It's been accepted. Amen. So the angel said, Cornelius, your prayer and your alms has been a memorial before God. Amen. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus. That he says, verse 3, he said, may God remember all your offerings, every seed you have sown, any good gesture, anybody you have been good to, any prayer you have prayed, anybody you have prayed for. You are going to tell God. That is what Hezekiah said. He said, Lord, remember all my good deeds. Amen. Listen, it is about time that you refer God to your prayers and your sacrifices. Amen. Excuse me, those who don't understand, permit me to speak to you a little bit, okay, please. I know Dr. Nisha and some people don't understand me. You know, the seeds you have sown, the people you have prayed with, amen. You are going to tell God, the Father, remember all my offerings, amen. Remember how I have cleaned the church. Remember how I have served in your church. Remember how I've offered myself, amen. Remember how I have prayed with people without taking money from them. Remember all my offerings, amen. Remember the poor people I have helped. Remember widows and orphans I have helped. Somebody, you are going to pray in the name of Jesus. You are going to tell God that verse 3, Psalm 20 verse 3. He said, may God remember all your offerings, amen, and accept your burnt sacrifice, amen. So you're going to pray to the Lord, that Lord, may you remember all my offerings, my tithes that I've sown, my offerings, my prayers, my good gesture, the people I've been good to, pastors that I have helped, churches that I have served. Open up your mouth, somebody, and pray. Excuse me. Open up your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus, that may the Lord remember all your offerings in the name of Jesus. Open up your mouth and pray. Masheka baba ya baba, lebre kada da broka, lebre kada da brocha, leka baba ya baba, le papa ya baba. Somebody open up your mouth and pray to the Lord, that may God remember all my offerings. May the Lord remember all my offerings. May God remember all my offerings. Open up your mouth. You are praying to God. You are saying, Lord, remember the people I have prayed with. Remember the people I have interceded for. Remember the good offerings. Remember my sin. Remember the tithes I have paid. Let it be a memorial before you. The Bible says in Psalm 20 verse 3, it says, may God remember all thy offerings. Somebody open up your mouth and pray and say, Lord, remember my offerings. Let it be a memorial before you. Let it be a reason why you will fight for me. Let it be a reason why you defend me. May God remember your offerings. Somebody open up your mouth and pray the name of Jesus. The Father, remember my offerings. Remember my offerings. Remember my prayers. Remember the people I've prayed with. Remember the tithes I've sown. Remember the seeds I've sown. Father, I pray, Jesus, may you remember my sacrifices, Lord. Father, remember my sacrifices, Lord. Remember my services in your sanctuary. Father, remember me, Lord. Remember me, oh Lord. Remember me, oh Lord. Somebody, are you praying? Open up your mouth and pray that, Father, may you remember all my offerings. The Bible says in Acts chapter 10, is that the angel appeared to Cornelius. Is it Cornelius? Your prayer and your alms have been a memorial before God. Somebody, your prayer, every prayer you have prayed, they are becoming a memorial before God. The people you have prayed with, the poor people you have helped, the people you have encouraged, pray and say, Lord, remember all these sacrifices. Remember all these offerings. So Psalm 20 verse 3, we are praying based on Psalm 20 verse 3. It says, remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice. Open up your mouth and pray. The Father, remember my offerings. Remember my prayers. Remember my sacrifices. Remember the people I have prayed with. Remember my fasting. Remember the seeds I have sown. Remember the tithes I have paid. Open up your mouth, beloved, and pray in the name of Jesus. They are becoming a memorial before God. Remember the people I have helped, the people I have fed, widows and orphans I have helped. Father, I pray, my God, may you remember all those, Lord, and be merciful to me, and fight for me, and be merciful to me, and open doors for me. Oh Lord, my God, oh Lord, my God, Jehovah, Jehovah, remember all these sacrifices. Le kababayabra kabayabra, le babababayababa. Lebre kababra kabayabra, leke bebebe la brocha, lebre lebre la brocha, leka baba baba yaba. May the Lord remember you every good gesture, every kind gesture, every offering, every prayer. May God remember them. Maguda de brosha, empire be a wabo, obia wane papa, erade enkai. May the Lord remember. May the Lord remember the people you have prayed with. May God remember. Tell God, tell the Lord, the Father, remember. Remember all my offerings, all my sacrifices, how I have devoted my life, how I have committed my time, how I have loved you, Lord. Remember, please, Lord. Oh, and be merciful to me. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 4. Psalm 20, verse 4. God bless you so much. Also, for God bless you. Psalm 20, verse 4. It says, and grant thee according to thy own heart, and fulfill all thy counsel. Amen. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus. I don't know what you want God to do for you. Listen, like I said earlier, this is chance. Amen. It is time and chance that makes things happen. You know, this is not planned. You never plan to pray with me, but this is chance. This is an opportunity for God to do something for you. Amen. Please take these prayers seriously, because something will come out of these prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are not wasting our time. Something good will come out. Amen. There's been testimonies of what God has done. Amen. And you will not be left out. Amen. This is chance. You are going to pray verse 4, Psalm 20, verse 4. We are going to pray. It says, may God grant thee according to thy own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. I don't know what you desire of the Lord. I don't know what you want God to do for you. What is it that is on your heart? Amen. You're going to pray. You're going to make your petitions to the Lord. You're going to tell God, Father, do this for me. Listen, don't be afraid to ask God for anything. Amen. Don't be afraid to ask God for anything. As long as it's not somebody's husband or somebody's wife, don't be afraid to ask God for anything else. Amen. You want to open up your mouth. I don't know what you desire of the Lord. Maybe you need healing. Maybe you need a breakthrough. Maybe you need discernment. Maybe you need the gift of the Spirit. Maybe you want to be drawn closer to the Lord. I don't know what you need of the Lord. But for whatever my prayer is that, may God grant thee according to thy own heart, and fulfill all thy counsel. Somebody open up your mouth and make your petitions to the Lord. Request of the Lord. Whatever you want God to do for you, open up your mouth. If it is marital door, may the Lord open that door. If it is financial door, may the Lord open that door. If it is immigration door, may the Lord favor you. Open up your mouth and pray. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever you want God to do for you, you are praying that, Lord, this is what is on my heart, Lord. I pray, my God. God in shoe, my God, Maseka, Yebaka, Lipa Tutata, Lipa Tayabro, Libre Katatata, Maseka Tayaba, Mayebre Katayabro, Libre Tete Libro, Libre Kadadaba, Lebebebebebe, Liba Baba Baba Baba, Lebebebebebe, 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 Le Kadadadada. Somebody open up your mouth and pray. Le Kabro 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 Kabro, Libre. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I just saw. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. I just saw a golden shoe. That's why I shouted golden shoe. I just saw somebody, you know, I just saw a golden shoe. And all of a sudden, I saw somebody putting their feet in the golden shoe. Amen. A shoe that is made of gold. And someone was putting their feet in it. Amen. It is a blessing. Amen. We are going to pray. I want everybody to claim this for yourself. Please take it serious. I just saw a golden shoe. I just saw a golden shoe. And someone was putting their feet, their left feet, in the golden shoe. Amen. I just saw a golden shoe. And someone was putting their left feet in the golden shoe. Amen. You are going to pray. Listen, you know what that means? It means promotion. It means elevation. It means standing grounds. Amen. The Lord is about to elevate somebody. The Lord is about to give someone promotion. The Lord is about to give someone whatever they desire. Amen. Citizenship, green card. Amen. Favor. God is giving you standing, a stand, a grounds. Amen. Please take this very seriously. I saw a golden shoe. I'm going, you know, that's why when I saw it, I shouted golden shoe and I prayed. Initially, I thought it was just for me. But the Lord said, make it known so that they will all tap into it. Amen. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus Christ that as God is granting thee all your heart desires, may He place your feet in a golden shoe. Amen. You are praying that may God place your feet in the golden shoe, because that is what I just saw. Somebody just open up your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. The Father, let this be for me. I receive it for myself. I receive it for myself. Somebody open up your mouth and pray that may the Lord place your feet on the in a golden shoe in the mighty name of Jesus. And right into two and no more, open up your mouth and pray. Makata taria brata, lebre de breta, libra kadi brosha, makata da bayaba, lebebebe de bebe, lekaba bayababa, lekaba bayaba, lekaba bayaba, lebebebe de be, lekebe de bebe de be. Le quebro la cabro se cabro le bre cabro 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 le bebe 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 le kaba ba 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 le kaba ba 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 ya ba. May God grant thee according to thy own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. May the Lord grant thee according to your heart. Open up your mouth. If you need promotion, if you need elevation, if you need favor, you need green card, you need citizenship, open up your mouth and say, Lord, may you place my feet in a golden shoe, a place of glory, financial promotion, elevation, financial breakthrough, access, glory, divine glory. Oh Lord, divine glory. Pray somebody. Leka ba 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 ba. Lebre kabra kabaya brata. Lebre kabre kabre kaba. Leka bra kabaya ba ba ba. Leke be 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 ye be. Lebre kabaya bra kaba. Lebre kabre kabaya ba. Somebody open up your mouth and speak to the Lord. The Father, may you take my feet. Father, may you take my feet, reposition my feet to a land of glory, a shoot of glory. Open up your mouth and pray. May the Lord reposition you. May the Lord reposition you. Oh, that your stand for you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 God bless you. Verse 5. Psalm 20 verse 5. Please get your Holy Bibles. Amen. As you are praying, make sure you are reading through the verse that we are praying in, praying from. Amen. Psalm 20 verse 5. It says, we will rejoice in thy salvation. Now watch this. Salvation is not only when, you know, someone preaches and you say, you lift your hands and say, I give my life as the Lord, I take Jesus as my Lord and my salvation. You know, that is the first step. But salvation is also when you are redeemed. Salvation is a transition in life, a transformation, a change in life. Amen. Salvation is when the poor becomes rich. Amen. Salvation is when the single becomes married. Amen. Salvation is when the barren conceives. Amen. Salvation is when God changes your life, takes you out of pain, delivers you from the hands of the enemy. That is salvation. Amen. Salvation is when you are redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Onyame jiu free te biye mua. And only incredible. That's why we say incredible salvation. Amen. Salvation. It says, we will rejoice in your salvation. Which means, there is a miracle that is coming to you. God is about to turn your life around. You are about to receive a testimony. Amen. That will make all of us celebrate. Amen. We are going to pray for ourselves. Amen. You may not know any those that are watching. You may not know the man of God that is on the phone. Amen. But we are going to pray for each one of us that we shall receive salvation. What that means is that may God deliver each one of us from every entangled, every hand or grip of the enemy. Amen. We are praying that may God deliver each one of us. May you receive salvation. Amen. May you be saved from sickness. May you be saved from immigration issue. May you be saved from poverty. May you be saved from barrenness. May you be saved from, you know, from divorce, from singleness. Open up your mouth so that we shall rejoice in thy salvation. And in the name of our God, you will set up our banners. Open up your mouth and pray. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, may the Lord deliver you. May the Lord deliver you. May we be saved. We shall rejoice in salvation. Oh, Nabasheka Baba. It means the single one will marry. It means the barren will conceive. It means the poor will be rich. The sick will be strengthened. It means in the name of Jesus, the one that needs immigration favor, they will receive favor in the mighty name of Jesus. The one that needs a job, they will get a job in the mighty name of Jesus. The one that wants to excel in their education, they will excel. The one that needs ministry protection, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh faithful God, oh faithful God, oh faithful God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for salvation. Masheka Baba, Spirit of the Living God. Neke brocha, kadara brocha, lele bro, kadara brocha, kene debre, kadara brocha. Le baba baba ya baba. Le baba 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 ya baba. Somebody open up your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. Leke bide makaba baya baba. Libre kadara masheka baba baba. May the Lord deliver each one of us from every form of pain, every form of struggle, every form of challenge, that we may rejoice in thy salvation. We will rejoice in thy salvation. And in the name of our God, we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions, whatever you are believing God for. May God fulfill them. May the Lord fulfill all your petitions, every blessing you desire, every glory you desire, every elevation you desire, every favor you desire. May Jesus fulfill. Jesus, may you fulfill, Lord. May you give us salvation. People are struggling. Your sons and your daughters are struggling. Lord, arise. Lord, arise, that we may be saved. Saved from poverty. Saved from sickness. Oh, God. Makadi brosha. May the Lord grant you favor. May the Lord grant you favor. We will rejoice in your salvation. Your testimony is near. Your testimony is near. Your testimony is near. Your testimony is here. We are going to rejoice in your salvation. The trap of the enemy is broken. The snares of the fowler is broken. Your testimony is here. We shall rejoice. We shall rejoice. You receive a letter in the mail, and it will be positive. It will be positive. It will be a citizenship. It will be a green card. It will be a promotion. It will be your elevation. We shall rejoice in your salvation. You will marry, I will marry. You will bear children, I will bear children. We shall rejoice in eternal salvation. In the name of Jesus. Makine brosha. Oh Lord, watch over your words, Lord, and perform them, Lord. Spirit of the Living God. Amen. Beloved, I am praying for you that each one of us will receive
salvation. Which means that wherever the enemy thought he had you, every corner that the devil had you, you are coming out in the name of Jesus. Every pain, whatever caused you pain, you are coming out of them in the name of Jesus. We shall rejoice in thy salvation. And the second part of it, Psalm 20 verse 5, it says, and I said, in the name of our God, we will set up our banners. Amen. The Lord fulfill all your petitions. Amen. In the name of the Lord. Listen, what that means is that you are about to receive a testimony and you cannot account it to anybody. You cannot say anything. You cannot, you will only say, this is Jesus that made it. Amen. This is the hand of the Lord. Amen. And so you are going to pray in the name of Jesus, that Father, when I get the salvation, when I get my marriage, when I get my children, when I get my green card, when I get my citizenship, when I get my elevation, my education, my ministry, my glory, my favor, may I not give glory to anybody. May the banner of Jesus be lifted. Amen. May I tell the world that Jesus did it for me. Just open up your mouth and pray that, Father, I will give you all the glory. I will give Jesus Christ. I will lift up the banner of Jesus. Just open up your mouth and pray the name of Jesus. That, Father, when you do it for me, when you do it for me, I will give you all the glory. I will give Jesus all the glory. I will not say it is because I am educated. I will not say because I am from a good home. I will not say it is because I am handsome. I am because I am beautiful. But because it is Jesus. Somebody open up your mouth and pray. Leba baba ya karabroshe kababa, lebre karabroshe kabrosha, lebre kabaya baya ba. Tell the Lord, the Father, when you do it for me, I will give you all the glory. When you do it for me, I know you have done it. Salvation in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Verse 6. Please don't get tired, okay? Amen. Verse 6. It says, Psalm 20, verse 6. It says, now know I that the Lord saves his anointed. Amen. Beloved, I want you to understand that God saves his anointed. God saves his anointed. Amen. He will hear him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Amen. You are going to pray the name of Jesus that may you be anointed. Amen. I know you may be anointed, but you're going to pray for more anointing. Hallelujah. I know you may be anointed, but we are going to pray for more anointing, more oil of God. Amen. The Bible says, Psalm 20 verse 6, it says, know now that the Lord saves his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heaven. Amen. With the saving strength of his right hand. Amen. Which means there's a condition, there's some exception. Amen. He saves his anointed. Amen. You are going to pray the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Acts chapter 10 verse 8, the Bible says, now this is how God anointed Jesus. Listen, even Jesus was anointed. Amen. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus. The Bible says Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and with power. Amen. You may have the Holy Spirit, you may speak in tongues, but do you have power? Amen. You are going to pray the name of Jesus. Listen, don't think because you are a female, you shouldn't have that power. You must have power. Amen. You must have anointing. Amen. When your daughter, when your son is sick, when your mother, when your friend is sick, you must be able to lay your hands on them, speak in the name of Jesus, and they will get their healing. Amen. Hallelujah. You don't have to yell. You don't have to scream. You don't have. They don't have to fall. If they fall, fine. If they fall, they don't fall. What is important is for them to get their healing. Amen. What is important is the results. Hallelujah. And so you are going to pray that, Father, may you anoint me. Father, may you anoint me. Amen. Just open up your mouth. Desire this. Desire this. Desire that you be anointed. Open your mouth and pray. The Lord, may you anoint me. Father, may you anoint me. Holy Ghost, may you anoint me. Open your mouth and pray that the Lord will anoint you. The Lord will anoint you. The Lord will anoint you. Even Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and with power. And the Bible said wherever he went, he was doing good, casting out demons, healing the sick, raising the dead. May the anointing of God come upon me. Somebody open your mouth and pray the name of Jesus. The Bible says, for God saves his anointed. God saves his anointed. God saves his anointed. The Lord saves his anointed. He will hear him from heaven. You must be anointed that God will save you from every trap of the enemy. Say, Lord, may you answer me. Lord, may you anoint me. Father, may you anoint me. Please don't be tired. Pray, very soon we will finish. But pray that, Lord, may you anoint me. Father, 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 may you anoint me. Let your anointing come upon me. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost come upon me. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost come upon me. May I be anointed, Lord. May I be anointed, Lord. Father, may you anoint me. Jesus, please anoint me. Father, please anoint me. Father, please pour your oil on me, Lord. 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 May you anoint each one of us, Lord. Spirit of the living God. Father, may you anoint me. May you anoint my hands. Anoint my mouth. Anoint my body. Anoint my spirit. Father, may you anoint me. Pour your oil on me. Somebody pray for anointing. May the Lord anoint you so that you heal the sick, you raise the dead, you cast out demons, you win souls for the Lord. Anoint you to be rich, anoint you to prosper, anoint you to be great. Open your mouth, pray for anointing. Somebody open up your mouth. Pray that may the Lord anoint you. The Bible says in Psalm 20 verse 6, it says, now know I that the Lord says his anointing. May you be anointed. Pray for anointing, somebody. Pray for anointing. May the Lord anoint you. May the Lord anoint you. May Jehovah anoint you. Say, Spirit of the living God, may you pour your anointing on me. The Bible says in Acts chapter 10 verse 38, now this is how God anointed Jesus with the Holy Spirit and power. Even Jesus was anointed. Lord, may you anoint me. God, may you anoint me. God, may you anoint me. Spirit of the living God, may you anoint me with fresh oil, fresh anointing, fresh oil, fresh anointing, fresh oil, fresh anointing. Jesus, as the deer panted for the water, so do my soul long after you. Pour your oil on me. Pour your anointing on me. Pour your oil on me. Pour your anointing on me. Somebody pray. You need anointing to be able to maintain your marriage. You need anointing to be able to excel in ministry. You need anointing in every area of your life. Without anointing, you may get the blessing, but it will slip out of your hands. Pray for oil. Pray for anointing. Say, Lord, may you anoint me, Jesus. Pray, somebody. Pray for anointing. The Bible says anointing makes the difference. For you to make a difference, for you to stand out in marriage, in ministry, in your company, in your business, in your profession, you must be anointed. Open up your mouth and pray. The Lord, may you anoint me. Pray. God, may you anoint me. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. May God anoint you, beloved. May Jehovah anoint you. Makuba tini brosha. Kebroshikata. God, may you anoint us, Lord. May the Lord anoint you. Listen, beloved, these prayers, miracles and testimonies will come out of them. Watch it in the name of Jesus. I'm not the one that will do it. Jesus will do it. May God anoint you. Psalm 20 verse 7. We've been praying with Psalm 20. God bless us all for a long time. We've been praying with Psalm 20. Amen. Verse 7. We have two more and we'll be done. Amen. Psalm 20 verse 7. He said, it says, some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. Some trust in chariots. Chariots and horses in those days is like Mercedes and Bentleys and those kind of. It means that some trust in their riches. Amen. Some trust in their speed. Amen. Some trust in their potentials. Amen. Some trust in their abilities and their skills. Amen. Just like Solomon said in Ecclesiastes 9, he said, the race is not to the swift. It's not by your chariots. It's not by your skill. It's not by your education. It's not by your potential. It's not by anything. It is good to have those. But he says, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. What's the name of the Lord your God? Jesus. Amen. The name of our Lord our God is Jesus. Why? Because at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue will come. Listen, at the mention of the name Jesus, miracles happen. Amen. By the grace of God, I have mentioned the name of Jesus for greater things to happen for me and for people. Amen. I've used the name of Jesus to see people, healings and miracles. The name Jesus. I believe the name of Jesus has done so much for you too. The name of Jesus is able to take a poor man's child and make them great and rich. It does not matter where you come from, the background you belong to. It doesn't matter what you have done wrong. The name of Jesus is able to turn your destiny around. The doctors may not be able to heal you because they are limited. Amen. But the name of Jesus is able to heal you. So he says, some trust in chariots, others in their horses. But we will remember the name of our Lord. Because the name of our God, which is Jesus, is greater. Amen. That name he's been given a name that is above every other name. It is above cancer, it's above failure, it's above deportation, it's above denial, it's above, you know, every attack of the enemy. That name Jesus. This evening you are going to pray the name of Jesus. All you are going to do is to just mention the name of Jesus. Amen. You are going to just mention the name of Jesus. You are just going to mention his names. Amen. You are going to call him the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Ahilimuhiri, Eremura, the Healer, the Provider, Jesus Christ, the Omnipotent. Just open up your mouth. He says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto myself. When you lift the name of the Lord up, he's going to perform a miracle for you. Somebody open up your mouth and pray. Just begin to mention the name of the Lord Jesus. The Bible says, Elijah told them, he said, call the name of your Lord, of your God, and I will call the name of my God. And we will see whose name is powerful, whose God is powerful. Somebody mention the name of Jesus right now. Mention your God's name. It's of some trust in chariots, others in horses, but we will remember the name of our God. For the name of our God is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and get saved. Jesus, 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 King of glory, we uplift you. We magnify your name. And we lift your name up, Lord. Oh, Ancient of Days, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Healer, Provider. Somebody just call his name, sir. Just mention the name of the Lord. Le ba 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 ya kada da ba ba ya ba. Le bre kada da bro sheka ba ba ba. Mention the name of the Lord Jesus. Mention the name of the Lord Jesus. As the Lord Jesus. We magnify your name. We exalt your holy name. We magnify your name. As you mentioned the name, the sickness is leaving you. Every pain, the devils are fleeing. The Bible says, at the mention of the name, every knee must bow, and every tongue could confess that Jesus is Lord. Leba baya bruka. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Verse 8. We will finish very soon. Amen. It said, they are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Amen. Those who thought they were ahead of you, those who thought they were better off than us, those who trusted in their chariots, those who trusted in their horses, those who looked down on us, a time is coming and the time is now that they will fall and we will be uplifted. Amen. We will rise up. Amen. We will stand upright. Amen. They will fall. They will go down. Those who look down on us, those who undermine us, this is a prophecy. In the name of Jesus, they will go down. They will look up to us. Amen. Listen. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2, the Bible says after Hannah had now received the child, Hannah was now testifying about God. It says, there is none holy as the Lord. 1 Samuel chapter 2. He said, there is none holy as the Lord. There is none beside thee. Neither is there any rock like this God. Amen. Now Hannah started to say, he said, this God, he lifts one up and he breaks one down. He makes one poor and he makes one rich. Amen. Oma ebi sunu a dibia brafom. Oma ebi di yeno ame bi edie ehia. This God, he is about to elevate you. Amen. Verse 8, Psalm 20 verse 8, he said, those who trusted in chariots and their horses, verse 8, he said, they are brought down and fallen. Amen. Those who look down on you and I, those who undermine you and I, they are falling down. They are coming down. Those who are fighting us, resisting us, we are praying that they will fall down and we will be risen. Amen. And stand upright. Somebody just open up your mouth. Those who look down on you and I, those who laughed at us, those who mocked at us, they are coming down. They are coming down. They are coming down. They are coming down. They are falling down. Somebody open your mouth and pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. May God elevate you and I. May God promote you and I. May God make you rich. May God make me rich. May God turn our lives around. Open up your mouth and pray. Those who look down on us, those who trusted in their chariots, they are going down. They are going down. They are going down. They are going down. We receive divine elevation. We receive divine promotion. We receive divine elevation. Financial breakthrough. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 Finally, last one, last prayer. It says, save. Psalm 20 verse 9. You see, we are done praying with the whole of Psalm 20. God is proud of you. Amen. God is so proud of you. Dr. Nisha, God bless you so much for staying on it. Amen. Everybody else, God bless you. Amen. Now, verse 9. It says, save, Lord. Let the king hear us when we call. You know, we are just going to thank God, the Father, King of Glory, save us. When we call in prayer, may you please hear us. Amen. When we call on you, may you hear us, Lord. Save us. Be merciful to us. We are struggling. We are in pain. We seem to be failing. Lord, save us. Lord, redeem us. Pray somebody that God save us. This prayer, you don't have to be too loud because you are talking to your daddy. Just open up your mouth and tell the Lord to save you. Tell the Lord to save you. Tell the Lord to save you. Open your mouth and pray. You are telling the Lord to save you. Somebody, you are praying in the name of Jesus that may God save you. Father, may you save us and hear our prayers when we cry, Lord. Holy Spirit, may you be merciful to us, Lord. Please, may these moments not be a waste of time, Lord. By this chance, Lord, may you perform miracles. Jesus' name, amen. Amen, beloved, I'm praying. Father, we thank you, we bless you. We glorify your holy name, faithful God. Father, we thank you for what you have done and what you will do. Father, I pray to seal every prayer with the blood of Jesus. Holy Spirit, so that our faith will be increased, I pray that give each one of us testimonies, Lord, that because of this chance, because they chanced into this broadcast, you did this for them. Father, do it for me too. Give each one of us testimonies, Lord. Father, that our faith may be increased, Lord. We bless you. We glorify your name. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 Beloved, God bless you. God bless you so much. I just want to encourage you that just as we took Psalm 20 and prayed, that is how you should be praying. Amen. That is how you should be praying. When you pray like this, it becomes powerful because you are using the word of God. Bible says in Hebrews 4:12, that the word of the Lord is very active and sharper. It is likened unto a double-edged sword. Amen. It casts through marrows and pierces through, listen, spirits. Listen, they say spirits don't die, right? But the word of God is able to pierce through them. Amen. So the word of God is able to disintegrate spirits. Amen. The word of God is able to disintegrate, disengage and disintegrate spirits. Amen. It messes some spirits. Amen. Evil spirits. Amen. So please, whenever you are praying, make sure that you are praying based on the word of God. Don't just be talking. Don't just say, oh, in the name of Jesus, fire, 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 fire. It is noise. Amen. It could be noise. You know, make sure you are praying based on the... That's why sometimes people pray and nothing happens. Because you are not using the tools. How can you be fighting and be pointing a gun and there's no bullet in the gun and expect the person to die? Amen. The bullet of a Christian is that you feed your mouth with the word of God. So please, always be praying based on the word of God. You know, and like I taught you by the grace of God, when you are praying once in a while, make sure you are looking through the Bible and you are praying. You are reading it. You are reading. You are actually reading what is written there. It is prayer. Amen. So please, go back to the Bible. Make sure you read Psalm 20. It just has 9 verses before you sleep. Amen. And I know that the Holy Spirit of God is going to reveal mysteries unto you. The Holy Spirit of God is going to reveal mysteries and give you testimonies. And when he does, please don't forget to share your testimonies with us. Amen. It encourages us. That's why sometimes, you know, by the grace of God, we get a lot of testimonies. But sometimes I'll just post one or two, you know, just to encourage people. Amen. So that it boosts people, other people's faith. You know, and the Bible says, you shall overcome by the blood and the words of your testimony. So the moment you have a testimony, you overcome the devil. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for praying with me. For those who joined late, you may go back and watch the video and pray along. Amen. And I encourage you, especially those of us in America, I don't know what time it is in Jamaica, but those of us that are about to sleep, amen, those of us that are about to sleep, make sure that before you sleep, make sure you are playing, you know, Bible audio and leave it on. You know, make sure you are playing an audio, the Bible audio or podcast, and leave it on. Amen. Leave it to play before you sleep. Amen. It feeds your spirit. Remember, when you sleep, when the body sleeps, the spirit is up. Amen. When the body sleeps, the spirit is up. That's how you are able to dream. And so, how you feed your spirit, the spirit feeds on the word of God. And so when you are sleeping, this is a very important key. When you are sleeping, it is important that before you sleep, read something. Read at least one Bible verse or maybe a chapter. Read it. Read something. Now,
And after you've done reading it, make sure you are playing the audio Bible or maybe music, worship. Amen. The reason why I want you to use the audio Bible is that that is the word of God, and that is what the Spirit feeds on. Amen. That's what the Spirit feeds on. And so before you sleep, play the audio Bible and leave it open for it to be playing. Amen. Leave it open for it to be playing. And by that, you will see something. Amen. You will see what the Lord will do for you. Hallelujah.
Now after the death of Joshua.
Like, for instance, like this.
But the children of Israel asked the Lord, saying,
like this.
Who shall go up for us against the Canaanites first to fight against them? And the Lord said,
you see?
Judah shall go up. Behold, I have delivered the land into his hand.
Okay, so as you are sleeping, just download the audio Bible on your phone. As you are sleeping, they have offline ones so that it would not take your internet for those who have to buy internet on your phones. So just download the audio Bible, and as you are sleeping, before you sleep, just leave it on. Don't wait for you to be dozing off to do that. Before you close your eyes, leave it on, listen to it, and then doze off on it. Amen. It feeds your spirit, it builds up your spirit, so that you are able to retain your dreams, so that when you dream, you remember all your dreams, and it also empowers you to fight spiritually. Amen. It is very important. It's a very important key. Let's take it very seriously. Amen. Yeah, let's take it very. So when you are sleeping, make sure you are playing the audio Bible. And it helps you to know the Bible. It helps you to learn the Bible easily. Amen. Because you and I would attest to the fact that most times when you take your Bible, you feel lazy to read it. But with the audio, it feeds your spirit. Trust me, it works. May God bless you. May the Holy Spirit of God be with you now and forevermore in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, thank you. Please always remember me in your prayers too. God bless you. Bye-bye. Só foi para a gente na sua época.